Hey, what's up, everybody? Thanks for tuning in again for video 2 of our Build Your Own Swing series, talking about setup today. So how do we set up? Well, let's start here. When we stand straight, you can see that everything is aligned properly, okay? You have to be very diligent and honest with yourself when it comes to this, because a lot of people's perception of standing straight is this, where their stomach is pushed forward a little bit and their upper back is hunched over a little bit. So this is a very typical position that we stand in from day-to-day life. We have to just catch ourselves, especially in a golf swing, to really stand straight, you know, core squeezed, pelvis is tucked in, back is straight, and mid-back and up is also as straight as we can be. Almost like your chest is pushing out or very expanded, okay? So this is a straight back position. We don't want to get lazy and do this. So starting from a straight back position, what we want to do is we want to have our feet feeling like it's a little bit wider than shoulder width, okay? A good reference I like to have people do is have the stance wide enough so that you can comfortably do a squat, okay? If it's too narrow, it's hard to do a squat in the gym. If it's too wide, it's also hard to do it. So I want to be able to have the feet just a little bit wider than my shoulders. That way we can squat with ease, which sets us up to use the ground a lot better as we move forward in the golf swing. So from a very straight standing position, we're gonna take our feet to be a little bit wider than shoulder width. From here, once we have our feet a little bit wider than shoulder width, we're gonna add a little bit of knee flex so that our pressure is in the heel side to middle of our feet while our back is still straight. And then we're gonna put this club on our hip bone and just push it back to help us hip hinge properly, okay? You can see when I hip hinge, my back is still pretty straight and I haven't moved forward at all. A lot of people get lazy with the step, so after the knee bend, what they do instead is just hunch forward, and you can see that now my head is very forward compared to where my hands and toes are, and that causes a lot of my weight and pressure to be in my toes, which I do not want. I want to be a little wider than shoulder width, a little bit of knee bend so the pressure's in the heel side, and then knee and then hip hinge so that my back is straight and so that my head, hands, and feet are lined up pretty close to each other, okay? And from here, you have your setup. So quick recap, stand straight, okay? Stand straight, good posture. We want the feet to be a little bit wider than shoulder width, as if we were doing a squat. And then from there, we're going to add a little bit of knee flex and then push the hips back to help us with a hip hinge. And from there, that's our setup, okay? And as a starting point, we're gonna have the ball just left of middle, okay? That's a good starting point to work with. And then as the club gets longer into the driver, it works towards the left heel. So let's just say short irons and wedges start from just left of middle, and then as we move into the mid iron, it gets a little bit more left, long iron gets a little bit more left, and driver goes in line with the left heel right there. Okay, so try that out. Watch that, watch video 1 on the grip, and we're gonna have more videos coming up talking about the rest of the pieces to build your own swing. Thanks for watching, guys. Any questions, leave a comment below, and we'll catch you next time.